needs it. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Mark Collard. I'm the minister who has the privilege of leading this service today, and I would like to express my condolences to all of you for the passing of Samuel Jacob Larkin Jones. Today is, of course, an incredibly sad day, a day where you have come to say farewell to someone you loved, someone who had a great impact upon your life in just a few short years that he had on this earth. And no matter how we approach this day, it is always going to be filled with great sadness. But I would also like to hope that today could be more than simply just sadness. That today, in some small way at least, there could be moments of pause and reflection where we give thanks for the time that we did have with Samuel. Though it be short, and though he be taken from you incredibly prematurely. Today we might be gathered here for a long service, just a few short moments. But I want to encourage you through the rest of this day, as you spend time with one another, to remember him, to share your stories, to laugh, to cry, to grieve together. I have a couple of poems that I'd like to start reading you today. They're in your order of service if you'd like to read them as I read them to you. There is a special angel. There is a special angel in heaven that is part of me. It is not where I wanted him, but where God wanted him to be. He was here but just a moment, like a nighttime shooting star. And though he is in heaven, he isn't very far. He touched the hearts of many, like only an angel can do. So I send this special message to the heaven up above. Please take care of my angel and send him all my love. My little angel, you've just walked on ahead of me, and I've got to understand, you must release the ones you love and let go of their hand. I try and cope the best I can, but I'm missing you so much. If I could only see you and once more feel your touch. Yes, you've walked ahead of me. Don't worry, I'll be fine. But now and then, I swear I feel your hand slip into mine. I have a tribute that I'd like to read on behalf of Samuel's mum, Gemma. Samuel was always dancing, making up songs and laughing. Every morning he greeted everyone with a big smile and a huge hug. He loved going on school trips with his classmates, and he had such a thirst for learning. He was so eager to grow up, he couldn't wait to get a job. In fact, he was going to have four jobs: a police officer, cleaning cars, working in KFC, and looking after animals. He loved going to the park and feeding the ducks, swans, and geese. Especially loved going at this time of year, as he would get to see the baby birds. He had such a zest for life that he put 100% into everything he did. He was a perfectionist and sometimes would get upset with himself if he didn't get it right the first time. He loved his big brother, Freddie, so much that they were inseparable. And many times after lights out, they would be giggling or jumping on each other's bed. And a couple of times I would be woken by an alarm going off, and it was when they decided to set the alarm so that they could have a midnight feast. I'm so glad that I had the chance to take them to Spain last year so that he got to fly on an aeroplane. He loved it, and he had made a list of the many countries that he had wanted to go to. One country in particular was South America. I miss you, Samuel. We all do, and I hope that you will visit us from time to time. but also that you are okay where you are and that you will visit South America. Love eternally, Mum. Samuel, or Sammy as he was often known, was born on the 27th of July 2012 at King's Cross Hospital in London. His one brother, Freddie, who we've already talked about, whom he loved very much and was protective of. He would give him cuddles on a regular day basis and help him with many things. He was a funny, clever, boisterous little boy who could never stand still. He would often write funny little songs, and as we've already heard, he would welcome everyone with a wonderful hug. He could be naughty on occasions, but would argue that he wasn't. Sometimes he would say, "It upsets me when you say no to me." He certainly had personality. He was part of a school council and loved attending the meetings. And during the jumble sales at school, he would be found on the tombola. And interestingly, he used to win a lot. Sammy loved animals. And on one occasion, he went on a school trip to Westminster Abbey. And on noticing the famous cat, he decided that he would like to take it home. So much so that his bag had to be checked by one of the teachers at the end of the day just to check that in fact he had done so. Sammy loved chocolate. He loved bacon. He loved learning to swim. And as evidenced by so many of you today, his favorite color was blue. In fact, he had wonderful blue eyes. Sadly, Sammy became ill. And after just a short period of time, at his home, on the 30th of April, 2019, aged just 6 years of age, Sammy passed away. You know, when I'm asked to take a service such as this, I really am reminded that life is a gift. For most of us, I guess we get somewhere between 60, 70, or 80 years, and occasionally we hear a story, or we meet a family, like this one today, where life was not long at all. But whether life is long or whether life is short, I think it is worth pausing to appreciate the gift of life. Life is a gift. The person you're sat next to you today, whether you know it or not, is a gift. And they carry the gift of life. I have young children, and when my children open the gifts that Mum and Dad have bought them, they certainly don't pause to appreciate the packaging or the ribbon or the bow. All they want to do is to get into the middle of the gift to find out what Mum and Dad have really bought them, the true value. Isn't it interesting, as we get older in life, sometimes we get that the wrong way around. Sometimes when it comes to appreciating the gift of life, we are fast to appreciate the packaging of a person. And sometimes we're slow to take the time to find out the true value of who somebody really is. For those of you who knew Sammy well, not just knew him, but really knew him, who knew his value, who knew who he really was on the inside, today is such a difficult day, but it is also a day to say thank you for that gift of life that was here for such a short period of time. A wise man once said these words, that there is a time for every season under earth. A time to cry and a time to laugh. A time to grieve and a time to dance. A time to love and a time to hate. A time to be born and a time to die. Today, I would like to suggest to you is your time and your opportunity to say goodbye to Sammy. In a moment, we're going to listen to a piece of music that's been chosen by his family. And I want to encourage you to use this time wisely. In a few moments, we'll stand and we'll say our final goodbye to him. But as we listen to this music, why don't we pause and remember who he was, the memories that we will leave this chapel with. Some of you may consider yourself religious here today, some of you may not. This is an opportunity to offer your silent prayers or simply just to be grateful for Sammy's life. You might like to bow your heads. You might like to close your eyes. You might like to look straight ahead. But as we listen to this music, let us reflect and remember a wonderful young man. If you'd like to take your order of service, you can say the words of the Lord's Prayer together. You're welcome to say them with me. After that, we'll stand for the words of the committee. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Would you please stand with me for the words of the committal today? here in this last act, in sorrow but without fear, in love and appreciation, we commit Samuel to his natural end, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. You may be seated. That brings us to the end of our service today. In a moment, you'll be shown out of the chapel through these doors to your left-hand side. As we do so, we're going to listen to one final piece of music. Please remain seated for a moment.
Remember me, though I have to say goodbye. Remember me, don't let it make you cry, for even if I'm far away, I hold you in my heart. I sing a secret song to you each night we are apart. Remember me, though I have to travel far. Remember me, each time you hear a sad guitar. Know that until you're in my arms again. Remember me. Recuérdame.
Remember me, though I have to try.